It's Investigator Greg Edwards. Today's date, Monday, September 8th, 2014. Time, 14:03. Attempted phone call to Morris Pettit. Can I speak to Morris Pettit, please?
This is he.
Hey, Mr. Pettit. This is Investigator Greg Edwards with the Dawson County Sheriff's Office. How are you today?
How are you today?
I'm doing great.
And who is this? This is Kent. I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you.
That's okay. Investigator Edwards, Greg Edwards, with the Dawson.
Hey, Greg, how you doing?
I don't even know
if we know each other, but the name sounds familiar.
Yeah. No, I've never met you. I've heard of you.
Okay, I hope it isn't bad.
No, nothing bad. No, I've not heard anything bad. Actually, all I've heard is that you might be able to help me a little bit with this case. I'm working on the one with Tisdale with the video camera at Burt's Pumpkin Farm.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was just if you got a second, do you got a minute for me to talk to you?
Yeah, I sure do.
Okay. If you could, just walk me through what you've seen and how the event transpired and what unfolded, and just tell me what you've seen and heard. And,
well, that's what's kind of unique to this thing, because some people have said some things that weren't even there.
Mm-hmm.
And I visibly saw about the first 8 to 10 seconds it happened right in front of me.
Mm-hmm.
And I quite well remember what I felt at the time.
Okay.
Now, can I tell you exactly what happened? It happened pretty fast.
Right, I understand. No, you just tell me what you can recall. I mean, if you're not sure about something.
I tell you what I felt. Okay, I started to stand up. Because there was a fray, and I don't know how else you call it.
Mm-hmm.
There was a fray. There was, I don't know who this lady was, but she was flapping around, and she was about 10 feet from the governor.
Right.
And his wife.
Was this the lady with the, this was Tisdale, the lady with the camera?
Lady with the camera.
Okay.
And Tony Wooten, who I know,
uh-huh.
Officer Tony Wooten, who I do know. He's right. In Rotary Club with me.
Mm-hmm.
Had grabbed her and kind of walked her out of the venue.
Mm-hmm.
And that's basically what I saw. It was about 8 or 10 seconds. And after that, I didn't even get up, because as soon as I saw that Officer Wooten had control
mm-hmm.
of the situation, because the first thing I looked at was Governor Deal was there, and his driver was nowhere to be around.
Right.
And the first thing I thought of is Governor Deal's there, and I still think about it. Okay.
Right.
What is your rank, sir?
I'm an investigator.
Investigator. Sorry, just call you Investigator Edwards.
You can call me Greg, sir. That's fine.
Okay. Well, I'm just trying to do it. Address you the right way.
Oh, I understand.
Due to your rank.
I understand.
There's been a lot said in the papers and everything else. I don't think Officer Wooten did one thing wrong. In fact, I go this way. I've refereed sports. I've coached football. That was my first job in sports.
Mm-hmm.
When you call a penalty, it's who draws, who initiates contact.
Right.
The lady initiated contact.
Okay, you seen her initiate contact?
No question.
Okay.
Now, I only saw, I don't know how long it was. It could have been 6, 8, 10 seconds.
Right.
Happened pretty quick.
Okay.
Because, and I'm going to say it like it is. It looked like Officer Wooten gained control of the situation in a blink of an eye. And carried her out.
Okay.
Because what I was worried about is, you know, I don't know who this woman
now,
was.
Right. Did you see him approach her when she was sitting there with the camera? Because, you know, they supposedly what had happened was she was told to stop recording, and then she wouldn't, and then she was told.
There were three different or four different people that sat next to her.
Okay.
At different times about the first little while. There was
right.
a slender, tall gentleman with dark hair, a good-looking young man
mm-hmm.
that sat next to her. Then somebody else said something, and I don't remember who it was, but it was somebody else sat down next to her. She was sitting right in front of me.
Right.
And I was sitting right in front of the mayor, and there were a number of different people that were right around us that saw this happen.
So she was approached by about three or four different people?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, when you say she initiated contact...
But I don't... You know, what I'm saying is that, do I know what was said between them? No, they were leaning over and whispering because there was a speaker
right.
speaking right in front of the both of us.
Right, I understand.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
And, I had no idea who this woman was.
Mm-hmm.
But it's, and I knew, go on, you ask your question, sir.
That's okay.
Very uncomfortable talking about this for the amount of things that had gone on before, we started talking the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, right. No,
I know what's been going on, don't you?
I do, unfortunately. Yeah, are you talking about with this situation?
Oh yeah, it's awful.
Yeah, it's gotten way out of hand, and some people just take things too far, you know. But did when she initiated contact with Tony, how did she do that? Did she
was flailing. She was flailing her arms. I don't know how else to explain it.
Right. Okay.
You know
I got
what I mean by flailing.
Yeah. Just
moving her arms.
Uh-huh.
All around, and I wouldn't call it struggling.
Right.
She was just flailing her arms, and the camera. You know, it looked to me that the camera hit him.
Okay.
And she was flailing her arms, and she struck him. There was no question.
Right.
And, this is quick. This is fast. I mean,
mm-hmm.
I don't know how long it took, but it didn't take long because, Captain Wooten got right a hold of control of it, if you get what I'm talking about.
Right.
Enough
no,
control that I quit trying to stand up and I just sat out. It happened that quick. And I'm
right.
not slow. I may be 66, but I'm not slow. And but I was very worried all of a sudden, and I don't know why, but I haven't gotten over it. I was very worried about the security for the people that were there.
Mm-hmm.
Because there were some pretty important people there that were right there.
Right.
And,
okay.
You don't act like that with a police officer.
No, that's
sorry.
That's true. I agree.
That's why I got a little, I guess, nervous.
Right.
The second thing, you hate an incident to happen, but she kept yelling, identify yourself, who are you, that type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's what she said. And it didn't, I questioned it because, he was dressed in black.
Right.
I mean, he was in a police uniform.
Uh-huh.
You could not tell that he wasn't a police officer.
Right.
In other words, it's a stretch if you say, I didn't realize he was a police officer.
So you think he was identifiable by what he had on, right?
Oh, there was no question.
Okay. All right. Now, let me ask you one. I got actually a couple more
and
questions.
And I'm not an expert. I'm not an expert on that.
Right.
I mean, has Sheriff Carlaw talked to you about me?
No, he hasn't. Actually, I was told
I know
to.
I know a number of the police officers.
Yeah.
Okay. Tony's in Rotary Club with me.
Mm-hmm.
I work on a number of nonprofits with, you know, the sheriff. You know, I mean, nonprofit activities.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm pretty active in, you know, I'm not retired.
Right.
But, you know, and what I was talking about earlier is what's been going on. There's been a great deal of pressure on me not to talk to y'all.
Oh, really?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Yes, sir.
But I appreciate your cooperation, and if you
if somebody wants to talk to me,
you tell them to call me.
They should know better.
Yeah, they should.
They should know better.
Usually, if somebody don't want you to talk to somebody, it's not a good thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, well, but I mean, they just you know, there've been some things said about Johnny Burt and Kathy Burt, and Clint Bearden and some other people.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I am not experts on those folks.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't right.
Yeah, I'm not either, but I can tell you one thing. Johnny and Kathy Burt's some of the best people around here. So.
No question. No question.
They are. And I don't know Clint really well, but I talked to him too, and he don't seem like nothing but a good person to me either. So that's just my opinion.
They're wonderful people.
Yeah.
Now, do I know them pretty well? Now, I haven't been around Clint, you know, very often in the last 2.5 years, but before that, we were pretty active together in Rotary Club.
Right.
But, I mean, these are people that are active helping people. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Mm-hmm.
Helping people less fortunate than they are.
Right.
And that tells you a lot. And they're not doing it for their own good. They're usually, especially with those three,
mm-hmm.
and the sheriff, they usually do it behind the scenes.
Yep.
And so does Tony. And, you know, when you, never mind, I could go, you can tell I'm a little fired up about this, but anyway.
I don't blame you. Do you pronounce,
sorry.
That's okay. Do you pronounce your last name? Is it Pettit?
It's Pettit.
Okay. Just a couple more questions real quick, just for the report. It's, I know your nickname's Pepper, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, but your first.
And I've been called that all my life.
Okay, what, how do you spell your last name?
P-E-T-T-I-T.
P-E-T-T-I-T?
Yes, sir.
Okay, hold on. P-E-T-T-I-T. And your birth date, sir?
8/17/48.
8/17/48. All right. And your address?
81 Holly Hill Road.
Holly Hill Road.
Yes, sir. Dawsonville, Georgia.
Okay.
And that's 305-34.
Okay.
One thing I'd like to point out, sir, is that that first little bit,
mm-hmm.
I had a pretty clear view of,
mm-hmm.
but after it went someplace else, you know, I didn't follow it. I didn't go in there or anything else like that.
Right.
I know some of the other people did, but I didn't.
Okay.
So I don't know what happened there. But I know what happened right in front of me. And it was quick.
Right.
But, you know,
okay.
I mean, let me ask you something. Some of these people, I mean, some of these people with the sheriff's department, they're not in trouble, are they?
No, huh? No, nobody around here is in any trouble.
You know, I thought it was set up. Serious, you know, it's just crazy. I mean, it was crazy. She was crazy. She just lit up.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, but, you know, I guess, go ahead, sir.
No, I was just going to tell you, I appreciate you taking your time to talk to me, sir. I really do.
Well, I just, I don't know why, like you said about the birds, I mean, you know, Johnny's a great guy, but how could you say anything about Kathy?
Yeah, I don't understand.
You know what I'm talking about?
I do. I don't understand it either.
And there have been. And, like, the boycott and all this other stuff, I just cannot believe it. You know, I just, you know. And I have not talked to the Burts, I guess, since before this incident.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the only one I've talked to is I've talked to Clint Bearden.
Right.
And of course, I'd gone up and hugged Tony Wu and told him everything would be all right. And I did that at the opening of the, Rotary Island Water Park at Rock Creek.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, my wife and son went there.
Oh.
Well, they didn't go. I don't think they went to the opening. They went down there like the first day it was open or something.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, what'd they say?
Oh, they loved it.
Well, you know, Captain Wooten and his wife and his family were there.
Yeah.
And, I put my arm around him and I said, it's going to be okay. And then I hugged his wife because everybody was hugging Tony.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I know them. And I said, Tony, may I hug your wife? Because nobody seems to be hugging her. Everybody's hugging you. And they just laughed and hugged her.
Yeah.
I told them it was going to be all right. And they just, they've had some people ganging up on them that, have nothing to do with Dawson County. And, they're just...
Some people don't know the whole story, I mean, it's actually pretty cut and dry. I mean, if you don't do what you're supposed to do somebody asks you to do it on their property.
I know, but I've been dragged through the press.
Uh-huh.
Everybody's been dragged through it. I consider myself in good company because, the people that have been dragged through the press and thrown things at is a pretty good group. So, gosh, if I'm going to be included in that, more power to me.
It's good company, huh?
Yeah, good company.
Yeah.
But, they're winging it, everybody. And if there's probably one thing that I'm not known for, and I'm fairly recognizable, not just in Dawson County, but throughout the state, and not because of politics or anything, I'm not known for being a liar.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm sure they don't want me being a witness.
Right. Well, that's
and I was
that's
on
the,
I was on the I was on the police report, so they went. They've gone haywire.
Yeah.
Well,
that's
and,
the kind of witnesses we need in any cases, honest ones.
Well, but this situation is so stupid in the reality, and yet so terrible the way everybody's jumping on people's bandwagons and you hate something like this to happen, but I'm not sure that it wasn't choreographed, and that's just an opinion, but too many things don't put together.
Yeah.
And I'm being serious, and I know that's probably been said to you about something with other people. I know other people probably said that to you. If you've interviewed anybody.
Yeah.
I don't know if you have. But anyway, you know all I know. I just,
Well, I appreciate your time, Mr. Pettit. I do. And hey, if you got any further information or if you have any questions, feel free to call me. Let me give you my number real quick. Well, you got the sheriff's number.
I've got the sheriff's number. And it's Erickson.
No, it's Edwards.
Edwards, sorry.
Yep, that's okay. No,
I was writing down, and I don't know why I put Erickson down.
Right.
Sorry.
It's Greg Edwards.
Greg Edwards.
Yep.
There are a number of people that work in your department, and how long you been with the Dawson County Sheriff's Department?
8 years.
You know Kevin Tanner?
I do. He was actually the one that hired me. He gave me this job.
Kevin Tanner has known me and probably knows me better than anybody in this county. Okay?
All right.
So, he's probably the reason that we moved here permanently.
Oh, okay.
In 2007, why we built a house here.
Yeah.
Because I met him before when we just had a lake house up here.
He's a good person. He,
yes.
he took a shot on me, and fortunately for me, it worked out. So,
hey, he took a shot on me, and hopefully it'll someday work out.
Yeah.
Hey, I hope we get to meet each other sometime on much happier circumstances.
I do too, okay. Sir. I do too. You take care, okay?
Okay, appreciate it. Bye-bye.
All right, see you, buddy.
in conversation with Morris Pettit.